Hey everyone, I went to Marshall's and I saw these very excellent gummies from Lady May Gourmet Gummy Teddies. They're vegan, so that means the texture is more chewy. I do prefer chewy candies to Haribo, which have gummy bears that are a little bit harder. I like when they stick a little bit in the teeth. So this one is dragon fruit. I tried it. It's very good. I actually bought a whole bunch. So there is blackberry acai, exotic fruits, mixed fruits. It's sugar-free. I think it's with maltitol. Yeah, maltitol. Key lime. And mixed berries. I looked it up online and they had a little bit more flavors. They had strawberry champagne, which sounds very good. And they had Kentucky bourbon. They have like a little boozy line, but it's not alcoholic. Irish cream. And I remember there was another one. I forgot. But anyway. And there was this other company that made similar bears. They're also kind of chewy. So there's Buck Naked Bears, which make cherry kombucha. They had other flavors. The one was grape elderberry. I wonder where it went. I promise I didn't eat it. It was pretty good too. I just wonder about the kombucha. Is it an addition for health benefits? Not too sure because I can't really tell that I taste it. I'm not a fan of kombucha. Do not get me started on kombucha. 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 It's kelp. Tea. I don't know why. This is called the same.
All right. I feel like I need to expand on the context here. So I'm traveling alone to Montreal, and I sit down next to another foodie. Instant buds, yay! He asks me if I like tea. Excuse me? Do I like... I had a whole blog back then about straight tea. So he asks me, do you know about kombucha? To clarify, this was 2014. Kombucha in Canada, at least this part of Canada, wasn't making good ground yet. But it sounded so familiar. So I told the guy that I wasn't too sure, that I may have heard of it, and his whole tone suddenly became condescending. How dare I, someone who claims to know about tea, not know about kombucha? So he snubbed me for the rest of the awkward flight. I was flying for a funeral, and maybe I wasn't thinking straight, but when I came back home, I went to my pantry and pulled out a can of powdered kelp, which was labeled kombucha. And I thought, what the heck, man? This isn't even tea. It's kelp tisane at best. Real tea is from the Camellia sinensis plant. Now I finally tried the darn kombucha he was talking about a few years ago. The black tea that's fermented with a SCOBY, that stands for Symbiotic Colony of Bacteria and Yeast, or Kombucha Mother. And some more recent research that I've done suggests that it has been out there for a while and got popular during the late 80s and 90s. But I've never seen it in stores until the last 2 decades, and I look for fun things to eat and drink constantly. Maybe Canada didn't get onto the same boat as the rest of the world. Besides, I don't see what the big deal is. It tastes like non-alkalized light beer somehow to me, and I don't like beer. Except sheep shagger on tap from Scotland. But that's another story for another time.
So yeah, that was it. Very delicious. These, they pack flavor. Yeah, these ones too. Hopefully it's going to be sold in other stores that sell a little bit of everything. Like Zellers. Because apparently they're coming back. So anyway, I've opened a few bags already. Got some for myself. That's it. Thank you.